Hi, and welcome to another tech story. Now that we are finished with our SXE servers, domain controller slash DNS and vCenter, we are ready to start creating labs and practicing. Now, if you missed those sessions, you're gonna find a card up there to the right or the left. Please go ahead and click on that, or otherwise you can continue watching. Now, in the next part, we will focus on DNS. Now, DNS is a crucial part of any IT infrastructure. So now here's the scenario we will implement. Now imagine you're the IT officer or administrator in a company that have several branches in different locations. You have your internal DNS server in the main branch. In this case, it's techstory.local. We want branch 1 to have its own subdomain and branch 2 to have another subdomain. But we want those sites to manage their own DNS domain and not the main server. So what we will do is create a delegation from the main server to the branch server. To make this even more interesting, let's say our budget is limited, so we're only allowed to have 2 Windows servers, but we need 4, one primary and secondary server in branch 1, and the same thing in branch 2, because as we know, of course, redundancy is crucial to any infrastructure. So the solution here is to use a Linux solution in branch 2. And that solution will consist of an Ubuntu system and Bind9 DNS software. After this is done, we want to create a couple of DNS cache-only servers to be used by the main DNS server to resolve external domain names. Now, this will make it easier and faster for our users to browse the internet. So here's what we will do today. We will create a delegation for the subdomain windows.techstory.local. And we will create one primary and one secondary Windows DNS server. In the next session, we will work on the Linux part of the scenario. And after that, we will turn our attention to the DNS cache. Now, the Linux part will consist of an Ubuntu system and Bind9 DNS software. So here, let's take a quick look at the DNS diagram we will be using. As I mentioned, here is branch 1, which will have the Windows subdomain, which is windows.techstory.local. So any queries that have to do with that subdomain will come to those servers. And here is our branch 2 location, which will have the linux.techstory.local subdomain. And both those servers will be responsible for that. So any query that will come to the main server that hosts techstory.local asking about those domains will be forwarded to those DNS servers. After we have finished this, we will work on creating 2 DNS cache-only servers, and these will be allowed to do recursive query to the internet. Now, any DNS query that will come to our main server will be forwarded to those cache-only servers, which in turn will look for that domain name and return the information so that our DNS server doesn't have to contact the internet directly. Now, I must say, I'm really excited about this lab, and I hope you are too, but due to the length of this scenario, I will be dividing this lab into multiple sessions to keep the video length reasonable. So without any further ado, let's get started. So I have already prepared 2 Windows servers VMs. If you're not sure how to install Windows Server, you can watch my video on installing Windows Server 2016. You will find a card appearing right about now, up there to the right or the left. Now, I will manage all servers remotely using Windows Server Remote Tools, or RSAT for short, on my Windows 10 machine. If you're not sure how to do that, I will leave a link in the description for an article demonstrating how to install RSAT on Windows 10. However, in some cases, you are unable to find RSAT following the steps in the article. So in that case, you can download RSAT manually using the second link in the description, then follow along the article to install it manually. Or otherwise, you can just open your VM machine directly and follow along without installing RSAT tools. I'm just doing this because I get better resolution if I use my own PC instead of the VM, and more canvas to work with. So the first thing we will do here is to open tools, and then I will go to DNS, and I will add all my 3 servers. I've already added this, but I will demonstrate how to do that Now, after my DNS manager opens, I can right-click and click on connect to DNS server, add the computer name or the IP address. So I already did that. I have my DC01, which is my domain controller slash my main DNS server that is hosting the domain techstory.local. Here are the two servers I installed, when NS1 and when NS2. In both, I have installed DNS role. If you're not familiar with that, you can check my video on installing Windows Server. I go over how to install DNS server role. You will find the card again up there to the right or the left now. So now the first thing we will do, because we want to have a delegated subdomain that will be handled by both our servers, NS1 and NS2. Now the subdomain for the Windows servers will be called windows.techstory.local. Of course, if this is a branch, it would be called branch 1 or branch 2 or whatever the branch name is. But in this case, just to make it clear which are the Windows servers and which are the Linux servers, we will call the subdomains by the operating systems. So here we will create a forward lookup zone in NS1 and then create a secondary zone in NS2 just for redundancy's sake. And then we will delegate this from the main DNS server. So let's get started. Here on my when NS1, I will right click on forward lookup zone and I will create new zone. Click next. I will create a primary zone. Next, and the zone name will be windows.techstory.local. Hit next, and I have no problem with the file name being this. I will hit next. I will not allow dynamic updates. I will leave this checked. Hit next, and finish. I will do the same thing with NS2, but with the difference that it will be a secondary lookup zone. I will again right click on forward lookup zones, click on new zone, hit next, then choose a secondary zone, hit next, and the zone name will be windows.techstory.local, hit next, and here's asking for the primary DNS server, and for this 10.10.10.110, which is the IP address for NS1, hit next, and finish. Now, as you can see, I have my secondary zone and my primary zone here. Now, after we did this, we need to go back to NS1 and allow zone transfer to that server. So we're going to right click on the zone we created, hit properties, then go to zone transfer only to the following servers to make it more secure. And the server will be 10.10.10.103. And I will hit OK. Apply and OK. And let's create a test A record. I'm going to right click, hit new host A record. I'm going to call this test and I'm going to give it a bogus IP address of 1111, for example. Add host, done. Now I'm going to go back to NS2. Here is my secondary zone, and as we can see, that test record has been transferred from my primary to the secondary zone. Now this is great. We have created a primary DNS zone and a secondary DNS zone. Now the next step we will do is to actually create the delegation to those servers. Now I will go to my DC01, which is hosting my techstory.local DNS zone. I will right click on my techstory.local zone and I will click on new delegation. Now you can create a subdomain, basically if you clicked on new domain and just created a subdomain within this DNS server. But in this case, all queries to that subdomain will be resolved by the server and all records will be stored there, which is not what we want here. We want all the records and all the responsibility or administrative responsibility lies within the NS1 and NS2 servers for that subdomain. So, for example, we want the IT administrators team there to be responsible for that, or we want to distribute the load between all the servers. Having delegations between DNS servers is very useful and has a lot of benefits. So I'm going to click on new delegation. I'm going to click next. Now in this screen, I will enter my primary DNS server for the subdomain. which is when-ns1.windows.textstory.local. But of course, this will not be resolved because there is no record of this server. So I will just add the IP address, which is 10.10.10.102. Hit enter and just give it a minute. Fantastic. And I will hit OK. I will add another server, which is the secondary, which is NS2. And I will add the IP address for this, which is 10.10.10.103. Hit enter. And it resolved. Fantastic. Hit next and finish. And as we can see, we have our windows.textstory.local subdomain zone has been delegated to NS1 and NS2. So let's go ahead and test to see if the delegation working. Now I'm going to open my CMD or command prompt. You can do this by pressing the Windows key in your keyboard and R, then type CMD and enter. And I'm going to NS lookup test.windows.textstory.local. And I'm going to use the server 10.10.10.110, which is win-ns1. Hit enter. And there we go. Directly, we can resolve it. We can do this if it's a normal DNS primary zone with no delegation. So to check the delegation, we will do the same thing. But instead of using win-ns1 as our DNS server, we will use our DC1. Which is delegating this to NS1. Hit enter, and as we can see, it is working. And here you can see that this is not an authoritative answer because it's coming from 101, which is not the server responsible for this domain. So what happened here is that we contacted DC1, which in turn has the delegation for Windows. So when it saw that this is test.windows, it went ahead and contacted the NS1 server and got us the results back. Now we got a lot of things done in this session, and I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did. In the next session, we will focus on the Linux part of this equation, and we will be using Ubuntu and bind 9 for this. Please don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next session.